Hello everyone, welcome to the video tutorial series of the operating system. I am your instructor Varshita. Let's start our lecture series. Okay, so today at the end of this video, you will be able to learn about the reader-writer problem. This is the one of the classical IPC problem that we will see today in this lecture. Okay, so what is the reader-writer problem exactly? So in an operating system, we will deal with various processes, and these various processes may use the files or may use some data that is present in the system. So basically, we perform the basic two types of operations, which are read and write. Whether the process will read the data or whether the process will write the data, whether the process will update the data. So that is also the write operations. Got it? So basically, these two operations will be performed on the data that is shared between the processes or that is stored in the database. All these processes can perform these two operations. What? That is read and write. Now, what problems will arise this read and write? So, first problem is what? If the process is writing something on a file, then another process also starts writing on the same file, then it will create the inconsistency. So, which data will correct? Of the process 1, for example, process P1 is writing something and process P2 is writing something on the same file. So, which data will be correct? The data that is written by P1 or the data that is written by P2? So that will lead to inconsistent state. Then only one process should be allowed to change the value of the data present in the file at the particular instant of the file. So first, for example, process P1 is allowed. So at that time, process P2 should be blocked, because if both the processes will start to write at the same time, then it will lead to inconsistent state. So this is the one of the problem. Now, next problem is what? If a process is reading a file, another process is writing on the same file at the same time, then again it will lead to the dirty read. That means, suppose the process P1 has read the value 7, but another process P2 that comes and it updates that value to the 9. So the process P1 is reading the old value, that is 7, and the new value is 9, but that will not be read by the process P1. So again, that is what? The dirty read. So if one process is reading something, another process should not allowed to write something. So it will lead to the dirty read. If it is because the process writing on the file will change the value of the file, but the process reading that file will read the old value, so that is present in the file, so this should be avoided. So these are the two problems that we should avoid in the reader-writer problem. Okay, so we can solve this two problems using the semaphore variable. Now all of you aware about the semaphore, because till now we have learned the concept of the semaphore. Okay, so we can use the semaphore variable to solve this problem. And this is the proposed solutions. For what? If a process is performing some write operations, then no other process should be allowed to perform the read or write operation. For example, no other process should be allowed to enter in the critical section. Okay, now all of you are about the critical sections. Okay, what is the critical section? One section where the data is shared between the processes. Okay, so at the same time, no two processes will be allowed to enter in the critical section. Okay, so here, let's see. For example, three processes are there. So what will happen? The one database is there. Now, process P1 is writing something. Okay, so at the same time, suppose process P2 want access for the reading the database, then it will not allow to read the database, because one process is writing something. Okay, then same way, P2 will not allow for the write operations. Okay, now again, for the P3 process, no read and no write is allowed. Why? Because P1 is writing something on the database. So at the same time, we cannot allow read or write operations for these processes. Got it? Now, another solution for this, if the process is performing some read operations, only then other process is allowed to do the read operations. Okay, no any other process will allowed for the write operation. If one process is reading the value, at the same time we can read the value. Okay, any another process, any number of any other process can read the value, but no any process will allowed for the update that particular data. So more than one read is allowed, but if the process is reading a file and another process is demanding for the write operation, then it should not be allowed. That means multiple read is allowed, but no multiple write is not allowed. And same way, if multiple reading is there, a single write is also not allowed. So here again three processes, one database, one power process is performing the read operations, P1. P2 is there, again it performs the read operation, then it is okay. And if it try to perform the write operations, then it is not possible. Same way for process P3, if it is perform the read operation, then it is okay. And if it perform the write operation, then it is not allowed. Got it? So this solutions we have taken in mind while we are developing the algorithm for the this reader writer problem. Okay, so we will use this two concept and solve the reader writer problem with the help of the semaphore variables. Okay, this two semaphore variables we will used in the program. So first semaphore variable is what the semaphore DB, and another variable is what the semaphore mutex. Okay, so semaphore DB, the semaphore is used to achieve the mutual exclusion property. Now what is the mutual exclusion? At the same time only one process is there in the critical section. That is what the mutual exclusion. So semaphore DB is used to achieve the mutual exclusion. It is used by the process that is writing in the file, and it ensures that no any other process will get entry in the critical section. Okay, and initially it will set to the 1. Now another variable, that is what semaphore mutex. This semaphore is used to achieve the mutual exclusion during the changing the variable that is storing the count of the processes that are reading a particular file. Initially it will again set to the 1. Okay, so these two variables we will use, these two semaphore variables we will use in the implementation of this reader writer problem. Now here, now let's start the algorithm for this reader writer problem. So here first we will declare the variables of the type the semaphore. So we have to declare one of the semaphore type. So type definition, that is integer semaphore. Semaphore mutex is equal to 1, that will control the access to the reader count, and then semaphore DB is equal to 1, that will control the access to the database. Okay, and next is the integer reader count. What it will do? Initially it is 0. So numbers of process reading the database, how many processes are reading the database, so that count should be maintained. Why? Because when we have to give the access to the process that want to write, so at that time we have to check whether the count is 0 or not. If the reader count is 0, then that process will be allowed to access the database. Okay. Now, void reader, for the reader process, what will happen? While true, that means while the reader want to read the database, so it will down the mutex variable. So that means it will gain the access to the reader count. Reader count is what? Reader count is equal to reader count plus 1. Now reader is there, so count should be increased. So reader count is equal to reader count plus 1. Now if the reader count is equal to 1, so that means this is the first process to read the database. So what will happen? Down DB. That means no any writer process can access the database. So it will down the DB. Up mutex, that means it allow the another process to access the database for the reading purpose. So up mutex, then read database, then down mutex, that means it gained the access to the reader count. Reader count is equal to count minus 1. So that means if any process is leaving the database, so at that time we have to decrease the count. So if reader count is equal to 0, okay, so as I told you in earlier slide, so if reader count is equal to 0, we have to up the DB. That means what? Now the writer process will get the access in the database. Okay, if reader count is 0, then up mutex, that will allow the process to access the reader count, and after that use read data. Okay, so this process will be performed to the reader side. So first what it will do, it will down the mutex, the reader count will be incremented, and if the reader count is 1, what we have to do, we have to down the DB. So if one process is active in reading the database, no any other process will allow for writing the database. Okay, then again we have to check the, if the reader count is equal to 0, then we have to do the up DB. That means the writer process will allow to enter in the critical section so that it can update the database. Now what will perform at the writer side? So void writer, while true, that means while the writer want to write in the database. Okay, so what it will do, create the data, the data that the writer process want to write. So it will create the data that is in the non-critical section. Now down DB, so that means it will gain the access to the database, and it will write the database, write the information to the database, and then it will up the DB. So when the writer process will up the DB, so at that time any other reader process will get access to the database and it can read the data. So this steps will be followed to the writer side. So this is the algorithm for the reader-writer problem. Now what is the problem with the reader-writer? Okay, so writer come along the writer cannot be admitted to the database since writer have the exclusive access. As long as one reader is active, subsequent readers are admitted. Because reader doesn't have the exclusive access, multiple readers are allowed to read at the same time. So what will happen? If new reader arrive at every 2 seconds and each reader will take the 5 seconds to do the work, writer will never get in. That means writer will never get chance to access the critical section. So like this way, writer have to wait and wait. So starvation will be there for the writer. Okay, so to prevent this situation, when reader arrives and writer is waiting, the reader is suspended behind the writer instead of being admitted immediately. Okay, so we should have to follow the queue like first come first serve, like this way. So if writer comes and at the same time reader comes, okay, so it may be possible that we have to stop, we have to suspend the reader process because writer have to wait and wait. Okay, so this is the problem with the reader writer. So in this way, writer has to wait for the reader and that were active when it is arrived to finish, but does not have to wait for the readers that came along after it. So that means what will happen, just writer have to wait for the readers, the reader which are active in the critical section, but writer doesn't have to wait for the reader that are along that are come along after the writer. Okay, so the disadvantage of the solution is that it achieves the less concurrency and thus the lower performance. So that is the problem in the reader writer. Now what is the real life example of this? So for example, in a railway reservation system, reader are those who want a train schedule information. Okay? Also you have done this thing, you see the flight informations also, you see the train information also. So that is what you are reader. Okay, so they are called the reader because reader do not change the content of the database. We just see that information. We will not change anything because we don't want to book the information. Okay, we don't want to book the flight. We don't want to book the train. So what we do, we are doing, we are just seeing that information. We will just see what will be the price of this particular ticket. So that is what we are reader. Okay, so they are called the reader because reader do not change the content of the database. many readers may access the database at once. Okay, and the writer are those who making the reservation on the particular train. That means writer can modify the database, so it must have the exclusive access. So when writer is active, no any other reader or no any other writer should be active. So if the reader is having the higher priority than the writer, then there will be the starvation with the writer, and same way vice versa. Got it? So this is the problem with this. This is a problem that can arise in the reader-writer problem. Same way, for example, you are booking the tickets for the movie. So at the same time, you have seen the same seat, and that same seats free. For example, 1 to 5 seats are free, and that 1 to 5 seats again seen by the another user. So what will happen? Either you or either that particular person will get access, will get chance to book that particular seat. Okay, so that is what again a reader-writer problem that we have to solve while we are doing such type of implementation. Got it? Okay, so in this video we have learned about the reader-writer problem. What is it? What is the solution for it? How we can solve it? And what is the real life example that we are facing in this in such type of situation? So for example, ticket booking for the movie tickets, for airline reservation, for train reservations, etc. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. Remaining interesting topic we will cover in the next lecture. Thank you for watching. We will meet in the next lecture. Thank you.